Take the crown, drag them down. Take the crown to show them how.
We're taking the crowns, break them down. Hang them on the bedroom wall. We're dancing with bloodhounds through the town. Banging on padlock doors. And we're singing like, oh, 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 oh. Saints to the sinners, saints to the sinners. And we're coming for you, oh, 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 oh. We're saints to the sinners, saints to the sinners, oh.
Take the crown, crown, take the crown, crown. Take the crown, crown, take the crown, crown.
We all can smile and angels cry.
Take the crown, crown, take the crown, crown.
Lose ourselves and lose our minds.
Take the crown, crown, take the crown, crown.
We all can smile and angels cry.
Taking the crowns, crowns, break them down. Hang them on the bedroom wall. We're dancing with bloodhounds through the town. Banging on padlock doors. And we're singing like, oh, 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 oh. We're saints to the sinners, saints to the sinners. And we're coming for you, oh, 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 oh. We're saints to the sinners, saints to the sinners, oh.
Welcome, 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 XCW Galaxy. Here we are today at XCW Extreme King. Thank you for joining us today. I am JJ. I am here for the pre-show, ready to bring you a whole bunch of action. But first, ladies and gentlemen, a brief history lesson, if you will. Extreme King has been with us since the beginning in 2003. It's one of the biggest opportunities we have. Back in the day, you would win Extreme King, a 30-person battle royale, and go on to challenge the champion of Greed and try to take their title. Now, it's at Summer Mania, ladies and gentlemen. There it is, Summer Mania 21. And that's what it's all about, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, 19? Oh, yeah, I can't read. I'm sorry. Roman numerals. I suck at this. I apologize. Summer Mania 19. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen.
Who pays this man?
Nobody pays me. But, ladies and gentlemen, now, as I said, it goes on to Summer Mania, which is Summer Mania 19, not 21. I'm sorry, my Latin teacher would be very disappointed in me. There have been four winners, ladies and gentlemen, of this Extreme King Battle Royale to go on to cash in successfully and win the XCW title. Ryan Grayson, Carnage. We have Chris Jones and Fletch winning the co-winners, the only co-winners actually in history. Chris Jones was the one who cashed it in, though, ladies and gentlemen. And also, my compatriot on the table, Eric Blackheart, ladies and gentlemen. In 2022, the most recent one to do it. Congrats to him. But we might have another one tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Who knows? Venom, the only person in history to put it up at Extreme King and win his Battle Royale. He put his championship up on the line and said, if you win the Battle Royale today, you can take home my championship. You win. But nobody could take him. He won. I remember the most, if not the most, dominating XCW title run in history, ladies and gentlemen. But before we get to the Battle Royale at the top of the show, ladies and gentlemen, we have a whole bunch extra for you. Of course, the XCW title on the line. Tommy defending against Eric Mason. Eric Mason winning the... People aren't happy about that one, ladies and gentlemen, but I'm excited to see it. That's going to start off our show. It's going to be a banger. You do not want to miss it. Eric Mason earn the opportunity, and we'll see if Tommy hopefully can come out with the XCW title and defend it against him. Also going to have the XCW titles going to be defended, ladies and gentlemen. The Outliers, a huge, huge, we'll hear from them a little bit later on the pre-show, but making a huge splash in the tag team division right now. We'll see if they're able to hold onto their titles against EBW in a Pandora's Box match later tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And we also have Jackson Law defending his EBW title. He's had a stranglehold on it, but boy, Julian Boyd Jacobs, he has won a triple threat match. He has earned the opportunity tonight, and he may walk out EBW champion. We may have a new one there as well, ladies and gentlemen. And the rivalry between Corey Lee and Hunter Hauken heating up once again and at a fever pitch tonight, ladies and gentlemen, taking on each other in a trunk match leading up to that Extreme King Battle Royale. Ladies and gentlemen, our main event, 30 men enter, one leaves with a shot at the title at SummerMania 19. But before we get to that, ladies and gentlemen, you know we have some pre-show action to get to. But before we get to our first match, we are going to bring up our first interview guest. And today it is going to be some from the tag team division. The real ones, please join me up on stage if you would be so kind. Well, guys, how we doing? How we doing? Good to see you here. Good to see you here.
You know, this camera wants to see your beautiful face.
Woo! Here we are. We have two dynamos of the tag team division here. While things have not exactly gone according to plan lately, you know what? I have faith in you guys. I think today may be the chance to get things back on track. How are we feeling? Are you ready?
We were the tag team division, JJ, if you remember correctly. There was about 180 days, about half a year that we ran the tag team division. So today we're feeling pretty good. I think we're going to go into the Battle Royal. Rob's going to eliminate himself. He's going to let Justin Parsley go on to Summer Mania to face Tommy the Man Merriman for the World Championship.
Really?
And I think that's how Extreme King goes, right?
Rob Slater, everybody!
Yeah.
Rob Slater, baby!
Yeah.
He can touch the roof if he wanted to.
Okay, Rob?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Okay.
On another note, last week,
he's getting
last
show. From the host.
Okay, a little bit of miscommunication between us. Alright, I know. Been on the downfall ever since losing those tag titles. We'll get them back.
It's the spirit, that's what I'm talking about.
And I know miscommunication last week, you know, Ebonomix, formerly Blaze Entertainment, you know, they got the upper hand, but I talked to management. If you're down for it, I got us a rematch.
Ooh.
With Ebonomix tonight on the pre-show.
Ooh, okay.
We get back on track. Once we get back on track, the Battle Royal, Extreme King, maybe Justin Parsley goes on to Summer Mania. Maybe, you know, there can only be one man or woman that wins.
That's true. The essential one. I don't know.
What do you say? Let bygones be bygones.
Teams? Buddies?
Me and you against Blaze Entertainment, formerly Blaze Entertainment.
Former tag champs
versus former tag champs. I like that.
Mm-hmm.
Is that tonight?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All
right.
Yeah, we're there. Right. We're there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Well, heck yeah, that's what we love to see. You guys are going to be right taking now on formerly Blaze Entertainment. I think that's about to happen here very shortly, ladies and gentlemen. Anything you guys would like to say? Anything else before? I'm so glad you guys picked it up and repaired things. You know, maybe that dominating run can continue, but the Outlaws are tag team champions. You got to earn that championship first, but
anything you want to say?
I think we've earned it before. We'll do it again. And once I go on to Summer Mania to face Tommy the Man Merriman for the World Championship after I win the Extreme King, that same night, we'll be winning the tag team championships too, buddy. How about that? Yeah. Real ones, baby.
You? All right, real ones. Well, I'm going to toss it over to my compatriots on the table, Mr. Luke Blaze and Eric Blackheart. They're going to be giving the commentary action today for our matches, ladies and gentlemen. And let's get that first pre-show match started right about now.
Thank you very much, JJ Blackheart, Luke Blaze. Are you going to be a little uncomfortable watching your former tag team do so much better without you?
Do so much better. They've won one singular match, but it's great to be back on the commentary table with none other than Blackheart. You know,
how's your arm today?
It's gonna be all right? a lot better indeed.
Right. Anyway, I'm not the worldly traveler that you are, but we do have that tag team match ready to go right now. The real one's taking on the former Blaze Entertainment. Let's watch Luke Blaze squirm.
What? Let's get it on.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Shelbyville, Indiana, That's the right thing.
The disrespect.
Let's not forget. Let's not forget that maybe he forgot anyone in the first place. Yeah, that Luke Blaze, sit the hell down. You're not doing anything to anybody. That everybody knows that.
I'll keep my cool. Maybe I did deserve that, but let's not forget who stabbed him in the back in the first place. His tag team partner here tonight. There's no way they can coexist two matches in a row against the real ones.
Their opponents already at ringside from the hills of Hollywood, weighing in at 230 pounds. Rob Slater and Justin Parsley, the real ones. Yeah. Tag team action. We're running back the tag team match from point blank just 2 weeks ago.
Matches in the ring.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't think that one hit you.
Hey, be careful, man. I'm sitting here too. Let me get hit in crossfire. This is why I don't want you in commentary, because you keep getting hit with something. And then I get caught in the crossfire. I didn't do nothing. Onyx taking down Justin Parsley with a... Well, look at this Fujiwara armbar applied by Onyx there, and now Justin Parsley managed to get to ropes. How are you going to feel if Onyx and Evan Phoenix go on to become, like, tag team champions without your tutelage? That's something that's really... I mean, they did it while they were under your tutelage, but what happened to that tag team right after that?
I mean, I saw it in them from the beginning. I knew they could be a tag team championship, and I let them there. There was nothing else to be gained.
Yeah, but they're working so much better now without you. How does that make you feel, Luke?
It was one match, Eric. One match.
See about that as Parsley catches Onyx off of that top rope into a powerbomb cover. Two and no. Only a two count. Onyx able to get that shoulder up and a tag into Rob Slater now. Living Kaiju Rob Slater in the ring now with his partner, Justin Parsley, putting the boots to him. You know, Rob Slater could stand in the other corner and still deliver those boots to Onyx.
I don't doubt that at all.
Man is like 700 feet tall. Here he goes into the corner with a big body splash by Rob Slater. The Essential One is in essential control. And now a tag into Justin Parsley. They're working like a well-oiled machine despite their differences over the past month or so. They haven't appeared to be on the same page, but they're looking like they're on the same page right now.
Tag team can have disagreements and still succeed. I know you experienced those yourself.
I mean, I've been tag team champions with every partner I've ever been with, but that's just neither here nor there. I just know how to... Some people know how to coexist better than others. Rob Slater back into the match as the legal man against Onyx, who has been just really cornered in the Real Ones corner at this point. Good tag team wrestling from Real Ones, keeping Onyx separated from his tag partner. They do not want Rob Slater, or they do not want Evan Phoenix in there as Rob Slater gets dumped on his head on that brain buster. And now Onyx able to get that hot tag into Evan Phoenix, and Phoenix immediately into work on Rob Slater. And Windows update. Blue screen. Rob Slater bounced off the turnbuckle in the corner.
Evan uses wisely and experienced combatants such as Evan Phoenix, you know, to the mountaintop. Let's see what he's about to do to Rob Slater.
He was a tag champ. He had the Money in the Bank, and then he lost the Money in the Bank to Onyx, and then Onyx lost the Money in the Bank to Brady Branson somehow. I don't even know how that worked.
Some way. We're still trying to figure that out. Evan.
You friggin' know how it worked. You were there. It was your fault. Why don't you explain what happened to that situation? Evan Phoenix pulling Rob Slater back up by the scruff of his neck here. This could be a very important match for either of these teams, because the whoever wins this could be in serious contention for tag team championship match.
It's all a haluva kick there.
That big haluva kick by Evan Phoenix. I felt that a time or two. Trust me, it's not fun. Two and Slater able to kick out and partially able to break it up at the same time.
Oh, no, wait, you be quiet out there. Referee Aaron is the best in the business, I just want to say.
You would say that, wouldn't you? Where's this EBW patch? You haven't sprung money for that. All the XCW refs have a patch, why didn't he?
Watch this.
It's your money.
It's lost in the mail.
Sure, of course it is.
Phoenix,
blame the United States Postal Service, who's done nothing but a great job.
Come on, Rob.
Rain sleet or snow. Both men are down.
Over here, Rob.
Whoever gets a tag here first is going to have the advantage, no doubt about it.
Come on.
Dina could, both members, the respective corners, just inches away.
Tag into Onyx. Tag into Parsley. Here we go. Oh my God! Parsley just about took Onyx's head off. Big drop kick right to the mush. Parsley in control. Fisherman suplex. Big fisherman suplex there by Parsley. Real ones are rolling here.
That's right. Parsley coming in like a ball of fire here. What's he looking for next? Nice scoop slam.
Beautiful thing of beauty by the first real wrestler. And now another tag in to Kaiju Slater. Here we go. What's Slater got in mind here for Onyx? Oh boy. Side rushing. Oh no! Struck by Rob Slater!
That's gotta be it.
And a tag into Parsley. He's got him set up. The real ones could have it here. Are they actually going to be on the same page now? Big body splash by Parsley. Here's the cover. One, two, it's over. The winners of this match, as a result of a pinfall, the team of Rob Slater and Justin Parsley, the real one. Yeah, I'm sure. I see the smug look on your face, Luke Blaze. I know you're smug about your former team losing.
Hey, just like normal, Luke Blaze was right.
Good job out there. That's
the real one showing why they are the real ones. Can this momentum carry over to Extreme Team?
I really hope so. I hope they're moving
back on track.
Back to the tag. Back on track. Evening of the tag team champions. I hear they're on standby with our friend JJ. So let's take it right back to my broadcast partner. JJ, take it back.
Thank you, Eric. Here I am, yes, with the tag team champions themselves, sporting these shiny new belts. The Outliers, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said earlier, making a splash in the division. You guys are tearing through everybody, and it shows. You guys are holding that gold. Going in tonight, though, defending it with a special stipulation. How are you guys feeling?
Well, I've never been a part of Pandora's Box. I've done a lot of things here in XCW, but I have never encountered this kind of match. But tonight, the main goal on my mind is making sure that EBW never claims these tag team championships again.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Brogan, are you ready for a Pandora's Box?
XCW!
Yeah, listen up, XCW, goddammit! Yeah. Woo!
Now, as far as the match goes, I mean, I was announced on the rundown that we were doing this bullshit, and I wasn't excited about it then, but now that I have all these people around me, my tag team partner next to me, I realize, what the fuck do I have to worry about? EBW comes out there with these fake titles, and now we have them in a Pandora's box. And if anybody has more experience with weapons in this industry, it's Fletch. So here we go. Like I said, tonight, Pandora's box, stupid EBW titles are going away, and now, I mean, what the fuck else do I have to talk about?
I know what we have to talk about, and that is that. Summer Mania 19 is looming. 19. Summer Mania 19 is coming.
That's 19, by the way.
And 19. We plan on walking in to Summer Mania 19 with the XCW tag team titles. And hell, we may even get a bonus and one of us walk into Summer Mania with a number one contendership for the XCW title after the night's end.
Well, I mean, you guys have beat EBW before. I mean, why not tonight? I know it isn't a Pandora's box match. It's unifying the titles, and I always got to root XCW. I can never be in EBW's corner. And like I said, you guys,
who can beat you right now? Who can beat you? But you guys, it's a big test no matter what. Even if it is EBW, it's a Pandora's Box match. You guys, hopefully gonna march into Summer Mania 19, ladies and gentlemen.
That's 19, by the way.
It's 19. The road starts today, ladies and gentlemen. The road starts today. And you guys, I'm not worried at all. I think you're gonna come out on top.
Not worried either.
All right. Anything you wanna say before we let you get back to the match and get back there and get ready, guys?
I think the Outliers and XCW champions will see you at Summer Mania 19.
Talking about, baby. I will never live this down, XCW.
I will never live this down, XCW Galaxy. Never. And I welcome it. Thank you. Well, thank you to the Outliers as well, the tag team champions. Confident as ever. And I can't say I blame them, ladies and gentlemen, because they have dominated that tag team division. We do have another match, but before we get to that, there's another interview, ladies and gentlemen. The match is going to be a banger. It's going to be for the hardcore title. Santiago Cruz taking on Michael Barrera's, Ref Festus, our very own, ladies and gentlemen, his son. Michael what? Christian. I'm so sorry. Michael Christian, ladies and gentlemen. You've seen him on XCW before. He was in Festus's retirement show. It was his retirement match as well. It was wonderful. It was beautiful. And now we get to see him again, ladies and gentlemen, in XCW ring at the Extreme King pre-show. Who knows? Maybe he could come out XCW hardcore champion. We'll see, ladies and gentlemen. But before we get to that, Michael and Santiago have a little bit more time to prepare. I'm going to bring up the EBW champion, Mr. Jackson Law, ladies and gentlemen. Please join me on stage. I'm not booing, just so you know.
Y'all are just mad because I got a belt and you can't even keep your pants up.
Teach me how to suck dick.
This guy stinks.
Well, ladies and gentlemen.
Only because your mom grinded on me.
I'm not going to say anything because he's right here next to me and he'll probably kick my ass. So, Jackson Law, you as well defending your title tonight against Julian Void Jacobs. He won that triple threat match and now he's coming for this. Are you...
It doesn't matter if Julian Void Jacobs is coming for my championship. Quite frankly, Julian Void Jacobs' only problem with me is the fact that I already bagged two of his exes. And quite frankly, on any given Friday night, I could go to the bar and take his brother home too if I wanted to. Heaven forbid I walk into the ring and still walk out as EBW champion, because that's exactly what's going to happen, and I'm going to send him back to doing his quack job therapy sessions, eating sour Skittles, being Mitchell Maverick's bitch.
Well, some would say you have some feelings towards Julian Boyd Jacobs. Not that way, of course. But Mitchell Maverick
is done.
He's with EBW now, and I feel like Julian Boyd Jacobs, he's got his sights firmly set on your title. He's not going anywhere. You think you're gonna actually come out with Extreme King with that title in your hand?
Let's be real. I'm gonna beat Julian Jacobs like a rock band guitar straight over the head. At the end of the day, I'm gonna walk away with the EBW championship, and then you all see that pretty little title right over there sitting on that throne? I'm gonna throw everybody else over the top rope, take that title, walk into Summer Mania, and walk out with three championships, because I'm the law of the land. When I step through those ropes, I lock it down and make anything I want mine. Okay. That ring is my jurisdiction, and all of those trespassers are getting thrown right over the top rope down to cell block F because they're all failures.
He can spell!
Well, I would ask if you're confident about Extreme King, but I think that answers that. So, we're looking at a future XCW and EBW champion. You're going to hold both titles?
I'll be the only person since EBW came back to do it. I'll be undisputed.
Okay.
Draped in gold, as the law of the land should have always been, despite what the little snowflake fairies at home might think.
Happy Pride Month, ladies and gentlemen. But that's pretty much all I have for you, Jackson. Is there anything else you want to say to your adoring fans before you get ready for your match? And better yet,
the Extreme King Battle Royale?
Fuck off and die!
Yeah, you know what? I do have a lot to say, but I've got all the time in the world to say it. The only thing these hideous trailer trash looking scum in the audience here tonight need to know is that I am going to walk out winning Extreme King, retaining my EBW championship, and be the law of the land. XCW is my land. And at the end of the day, the law is always on top.
I call bullshit.
Watch out, XCW roster. Watch out, Julian Boyd Jacobs. The law is coming for you.
He smells like mayonnaise.
We're going to have to see if he can retain it, ladies and gentlemen. Better yet, win the Extreme King Battle Royale, because as you know, it's 30 men. Two men enter. You keep getting another person added, and there can only be one, like the Highlander. We'll have to see if it's going to be any of the people I interviewed up here today. They all seem pretty confident they're going to come out at least champions in some regard, so we'll have to see. But, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be Santiago Cruz taking on Michael Christian in a hardcore match for the hardcore title, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be a bloodbath. You don't want to miss it, and good for you. It's actually coming up right now. So Eric Blackheart and Luke Blaze, I guess. Back to you.
Luke Blaze, I guess. You're an afterthought.
Disrespect, hey. Even after interviewing the EBW champion.
I don't know. I feel like your boys are going to get massacred in that Pandora's box. By the way, I'm undefeated in Pandora's box, just so you know. I've only had two, but I've won both.
I'll have to respect.
I've actually never been pinned in a Pandora's box match either. Anyway, yeah, we got a hardcore title match coming up right now. Here we go. Santiago Cruz taking on Michael Christian. Let's do it. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a schedule for one fall for the XCW Hardcore Championship. Introducing first, from Fort Wayne, Indiana, weighing in at 185 pounds, this is Michael Christian. Last time we saw this man was, he was wrestling Justin Parsley. That match is available on XCW All Access. Little thing. We also saw him wrestling Vestas not too long before that, also on XCW All Access. Crap kicked out of him by Justin Parsley, though. Let's see how well he fares in this match for the Hardcore title.
Looked death in
the
eyes about 13 times. I was in a trance about 13.
And here's our opponent. From San Juan, Puerto Rico. Weighing in at 209 pounds. He is the current XCW Hardcore Champion, Santiago. Santiago won that belt 2 weeks ago in that hellacious championship scramble, beating four other men for that championship.
I don't know if I feel so safe sitting next to this mystery box.
I don't know. I wouldn't. This is me. He might ask you to pick something out of that, so just be forewarned. Or he might ask me. I don't know. I've never been asked. I've been sitting here the whole time he's been wrestling.
Rick Cruz? Christian, ring the bell!
Here we go, match underway. Hardcore rules, that means no countouts, no disqualifications. Anything goes pretty much here in this hardcore match. Nice. Arm drag there, almost down to the ground, and now the key lock around the thigh, applying the most amount of pressure as Michael Christian rolls back, rolls him up. Hardcore tied on the line already, trying to put it away early. The longer this match goes, the more favors Santiago. He's a weapons expert.
Exactly, you know, the free experience. Nice clothesline.
Hey, man, you gotta have to... Cover by Santiago Cruz. Off of the clothesline, and Christian gets the shoulder up. I had the pleasure of calling Michael Christian's match with Festus Davis last year. That was a hellacious match, too. You would think Festus would be able to go like that, but he did. That was his last match ever, as far as we know.
Nice.
And he suplexed! Wow! Santiago usually just throwing weapons at people, actually pulling out the wrestling. Impressive.
Yeah, it is impressive. You know, the evolution of Santiago Cruz here in just a short time.
No one could doubt the skills of Santiago Cruz in the weapons department, but obviously very few have seen him throw wrestling maneuvers, but there he's doing it. He's holding his own with Michael Christian, who is no slouch in the wrestling department himself. Whoa, look out! Speaking of, nice little hip toss takes him out of that submission maneuver. Now Christian with the big body splash. And now Christian gonna go to the top, nope, to the middle rope. Look at this.
Like
with the greatest of ease, like very agile Michael Christian. And here's the cover, the hardcore title. We might have the match in before we even get any hardcore weapons introduced.
That would be a disappointment.
That would be a disappointment. I think he heard us. He's going under the ring. What is that? What does he got? Oh, is that an energy drink? Seriously?
Energy drink.
Did he buy a case of Liquid Death?
Could be stick ready to run
ring
through that fence here.
Hey, Liquid
second.
Death. We could use the sponsorship. Sponsor us. Oh my God, he's got that Mjolnir with the thumbtacks in it.
Mjolnir!
Uh-oh. Oh! And Cruz cut him off, and now is working him on the outside where this is completely legal. Right into the ring post.
Santiago Cruz is giving Michael the business here.
Remember, there's no countouts, no disqualifications, so this is all within the rules. Festus is only here to count to three. And look at this. Santiago is just pulling everything out of from under there.
Chairs of all kinds.
Yeah. That chair has no seat. That chair has a seat, though. And I think Michael Christian's about to have a seat right to his back.
Oh, God. This crowd is vicious. They want more violence. And Cruz is about to give it to him.
Oh, my God. What a chair shot. They're venturing dangerously close to our already set up Pandora's box. Like I said, the tag titles will be on the line during the main show.
Very invested in the outcome of that one.
I'm sure you are. Pandora's box is hellacious. It'll be nice to be calling one instead of being involved in one. And look at this, Santiago Cruz is like setting up a table. I think Michael Christian's about to have a bad day here. He's got, what in the world?
A hell of a chair tower here.
How many tables does a man need? Oh my God. Santiago is devising Michael Christian's demise here. This is insanity. He's got a double table set up. Oh, that's gonna be hell. I would not want to go through that. That's not gonna feel good.
It's gonna be a bad time for Michael unless he turns around here.
Up on the apron. This is gonna be bad. Oh no, wait a minute! Michael Christian! What is he doing here? He's got him set up. Oh my God!
Oh,
back body
Christ.
Drop onto the tables! My God! Michael Christian!
We're not here to check on the competitors here, rightfully so.
Michael Christian might be dead.
No, I don't think I've seen him move.
Jesus. Take a look at this again. Here's this back body drop. Santiago Cruz able to turn the table, so to speak. Pardon the expression. And Michael Christian goes flat on his back through one table. The other one didn't break.
Do it again.
He is alive. He's alive.
He is alive, but I don't know for how long because Santiago's looking to put him to the other table. And my God, still can't get it to break. It's just punishing Michael Christian at this point.
For fuck's sake.
Destroyed the chairs, but the wood remains.
Fuck the table. Fuck those kids.
All right, Jammin.
Wait a minute. Hold up.
Santiago picking up Michael Christian after the body slam. Christian can barely move. Michael Christian can barely move, and Santiago's got to drag him back to his feet.
See, he's got in store here.
Oh, back suplex onto the apron by Michael Christian.
Just the reversal that Michael Christian needs to get back in this match.
He got himself a second win. What in the world? What in the world are you doing? You're insane. Oh, my God, body splash onto the chair. Onto Santiago, onto the outside. Hardcore title on the line. My God, they're beating the hell out of each other, Luke.
I know this show's called Extreme King, but this is just a damn pre-show.
This is just a pre-show. Can you imagine what might be happening here in the main show?
One,
considering we got
two
count only. Santiago barely able to get that shoulder up. Considering we got a trunk match coming, we got Pandora's Box. It's gonna be insane, this show. DDT by Michael Christian. Santiago's in trouble. Christian kips up. Here we go. Could Michael Christian?
He's taking his shoes off.
Cheap shit.
Could Michael Christian just be moments away from winning the XCW Hardcore Championship? Oh man. Oh, what is he doing? Is he going for that double leg Boston Crab? He's got it cinched in. Oh my God, he's got it locked in. Santiago, center of the ring, nowhere to go. Look at it, he's tapping him in the balls. Oh, but Santiago able to power out of that.
All in for an Extreme Rules match.
I've never seen a Boston Crab with a ball tap before. That was some Call of Duty stuff.
Call of Duty execution indeed as he grabs this hellacious hammer.
Look out. Oh, shoulder to the head with the thumbtacks. Michael Christian's own weapon that he brought to the ring, unfortunately, being used against him. And now, Santiago with the zigzag. It's over for Michael Christian here. One, two, three.
Yes, what a defense by Santiago Cruz.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match is a result of a pinfall, and still, XCW Hardcore Champion, Santiago Cruz! Santiago, but there is nobody hardcore or hardcore right now than Santiago Cruz. We're gonna throw things back to JJ up on the stage. JJ, take it back away.
All right, well, thank you guys. I appreciate it. What a pre-show it's been, ladies and gentlemen. We said before Blackheart won it in 2022, went on to win the title at Summer Mania. The last time we had a winner was 2015, ladies and gentlemen. Carnage in 2012, Grayson in 14, and then Fletch and Chris Jones actually co-won it in 2015, and then obviously Chris Jones went on to win. But could it be the winner's time this year, 2024 Summer Mania 19, ladies and gentlemen? The winner of Extreme King could go on. They could face Tommy the Man Merriman. Who knows? Maybe they could face Eric Mason, depending on what happens today. We'll just have to find out, because that's coming up right after this. Ladies and gentlemen, that is our XCW pre-show. Thank you for joining me, JJ, here for Eric Blackheart, and thank you to Luke Blaze. We are signing off, and welcome to Extreme King 2024 and the road to Summer Mania. Breathe out and touch it.